live on YouTube.
Oh, is it?
Busy Broadcasting on YouTube live.
Excellent. Go for it.
Recording on you, it's playing on YouTube for Rana. So my wife is watching.
Oh, she's watching?
Yeah.
Excellent.
So my parents, my wife, mother in the UK, they're logged in now on YouTube. It's called, when it's finished, you can watch it at home. It's called Neotal Sales Kickoff 2016.
Don't touch these two guys.
Sorry.
No worries.
Neotal.
SKO 2016.
Ah, okay. I'll check it out.
Logging there for the YouTube.
You're just going to YouTube, do a search
for
Neotal SKO 2016.
Thank you.
guys, we're about to start. Tinesh, the NEO is outside.
Yeah, I pressed this thing by mistake. Oh. Love on YouTube.
I'm very delighted if they send me an official apology letter, please, by email. Took out lots of valuable information from their strat sessions. I'll just quickly say from our strat session, if ever you get a chance to go into a meeting with Shooks, you have to take that opportunity. No matter how bad or good that meeting is, you always walk out of there like you've just had a massage by Mother Teresa. It's just very philosophical and passionate. It's awesome. Okay, before we get to the closing of the day, we have our last speaker. He's our nominated special speaker for today. I don't really need to do much introductions, but I know he's very excited. Mr. Solid? Yes, boss. Just to announce, obviously Giovanni did 282% of his number. And yes, I think we're all going to take a lot out of him, and hopefully learn a second language at the same time. So Giovanni, can you please come up?
Firstly, two thank yous I want to do. The one thank you is to every single one in Neotel. every single staff member, every single salesperson, engineers, operations, order management, marketing, products. Yeah, today, what I am today. So you will see chocolate. It's only to you from my personal capacity just to say thank you.
Oh, nice.
The second person I also want to thank you is a person that is very close to me. Whenever I have to work late at night, weekends, early mornings, it's also my head home sales manager. It's my wife. She controls my pipeline and she books my holidays. So December, she already showed me Bahamas, so December Bahamas will be. Okay, so what are the six ingredients to my success? What did I do this year that allowed me to succeed? The first thing is, I need to believe in a product that I made sure that I knew the product inside out. I specialized, we saw one of the presentations that Schuster. I looked at the products, where am I gonna make the money? Because I'm a sales guy and that's what we did for. We're there to make money. I realized the internet is it's a value add. Gonna make me money, last month's gonna make me money. But I saw getting in the market, everybody knows, call center. And I went straight for every single call center market. And the call center is what really made me the numbers and made me achieve. The culture within the organization, I mean, it's fabulous. I love Neocom. I work for international companies, Congress. I work with MTN. In fact, I was one of the founders at MTN. Before that, Abid worked at Sprint Telecom. I was at Global One. Global One was owned by Sprint Telecom. The culture is very phenomenal. You have to fit in with the culture. When you employ somebody if he's aggressive, if he's got a temper, if it doesn't fit in the culture. It's something that really every manager takes into account when employing somebody. You will get a guy, you interview him, say, he knows A to Z, but he won't fit in this culture. And I love it because we got Spanish people, we got Indians from India, we got then the good looking Indians from KwaZulu-Natal, and then we got the beautiful colors that usually pitch up late, but I still love them. By the way, sales is a psychological game. You heard what Kennedy said this morning, okay, and I'm going to correct him. We are not bullshitters. It's all a psychological game for us to go out there and sell. When I say psychological, you have to learn your customer and your business. Shooks mentioned earlier in the presentation. It's absolutely true. If you don't know your customer, does he play golf? Does he watch soccer? What does he do? It's a psychological game. You study your customer inside out. You study his business. You study his customers and what the customers do. Why does he have customers? Who are his vendors? So you have to know absolutely everything about your customer. If there is no pain, every customer has a pain. Some of them will admit it. Some of them they won't admit it. They want you to find the pain. So I won't find the pain. What I do is I go and create a value in the customer. And what I did with the call centers is it's normal. It's about call center. They've got agents. The only thing is these agents are like robots. They've got a screen, they read a screen, the phone, they read the screen. How's it, Mr. Ventura? Yes, can I buy a cell phone? Yes, okay, contract. They read. So I cannot do anything. I cannot find a pain in that customer. So with the BPO, thanks to products that we created in the market, I went and created a value to the customer by reducing the costs. Automatically, I said, just give me 1 month. I'll put 300 sub-channels. If you don't like it, we take it out. None of them took the sub-channels away. And the 7 volume of minutes are coming through. Understand all your buying process. Okay, the buying process within your customers. Who is the buying process? Who do you go and take to play golf with? Who are you taking to rugby? Who's your sponsor within the organization? Who's going to sign the call for you? Very important to understand who are the people within the organization. This is what I meant, Kennedy. We're not bullshitters. We just don't tell the truth. We don't tell the full story. And me being an Italian, I never tell the full story. I was, we sit there, we're gonna talk forever. Because Italians love to tell stories. Don't lie again. Just don't tell the truth. Fava went down. Somebody went to the cops. It wasn't me. I must have been. Must have got that lie. It's possible. But I'll do something better for you. Customer expectations with commitments, and this is one thing I love it. I love it. I always tell my customers, if I do this for you, will you have this car by then? You have to make sure that the customer is committed, that there is a commitment from a customer, because if you're just going to dump a proposal and you just follow up, you don't know the buying process, you don't know the customer very well, you're never going to get the deal. So always make sure, if I drop your call rates, will I get this deal by the end of this month? Please remember, dear customer, like you running a business, I'm running a business. I also have to bring numbers and report to my superiors. Ambition and perseverance. I'm going to touch into this in one slide. Okay. Ambition is everything in life. Whether it's a personal life, whether it's a business life, we all have ambition. And nobody can prove me wrong, because since we were children, we wanted to become lawyers, doctors, we wanted the bicycles, we always had ambitions to achieve something, and we persevered until we got it. Personal goals. With ambition, there must be personal goals, and personal goals have to be in line with the company. Like I mentioned, you know, I wanted to go on holiday this year. I wanted to go to Malta. But I made sure that my goals were in line with the organizational strategies and goals, because only that way I could achieve what I have achieved to be able to go on holiday and to already plan my next holiday in December. Last year, I had my own holiday. I took my wife to Singapore and Thailand for the whole of December, or let's say 3 weeks. And that was because I persevered. I worked together with a company, with a team, to make sure that my ambitions will come true. And one thing that I do, I work 3 months ahead, always. Today, as I said, I've already done almost my second quarter without even having myself. I don't know what my target is, but I'm already ahead, because since I get paid 2 months ahead, I need to know that in June and July, I've got commission. Yes, I'm good. I will make sure that I don't give you the cost on the last day of the month. And I won't send back. Lastly, the most important thing that I love, and this is why the chocolates are also there. Wow your team. If you don't wow your team, how can you wow your customers? I always hear this, wow your customers, wow your customers. But if you don't wow your team, and you don't say thank you to your team for the things that they do for you, and going the extra mile, you can never wow your customers. About ambition and perseverance, there are two other key elements that come with it. And again, it goes with wow, not just your customers, but your team members. You have an ambition and you persevere. With ambition, there must be a respect. When you go within an organization, you have to build respect with your team to gain trust for your team to support you at all point in time. And I can see faces here that I can thank every single day. There's been days that I've been frustrated, I've found shoes. He calls me that. Or I'll send a WhatsApp comment, he comes back to me. Natasha, Sonel, everybody, Esso, everyone, I had to respect you to gain your trust for you to help me. And that was the only way that I could succeed. Now, when it comes to perseverance, you can persevere, but if perseverance will give you zero results. So, in saying that, there is dedication. Now, with dedication comes tolerance. I will show you now that if you have ambitions, you have trust and respect. Some people will become tolerant, but they will have a team that will back them up, or they will have a team that if you haven't built trust, that will walk away from you. And I will show you now, my favorite sport, being an Italian, Formula One. Yeah. I love speed. And this is what happens in Formula One.
Yeah, guys, oh my god, I'm too old for that. Too old.
Rubbish, not too old. We're just starting out, mate.
Constructive feedback, it's the best thing. If they mentioned today, they're coming with new products, with cloud offering, you know, with hosted services, with managed firewalling. There is, once you gain trust, that customer will give you everything because he wants the pain away. He'd rather say, I'd rather pay you to do it and I'll go and play golf. Which is what ASIO is doing, right? Kennedy plays golf and we work. One thing that comes across, ask for referral. There is one thing with me. One, I never take a no for an answer. You have to sell to me, why not? And if you remember those exact words, was at the Barry Mitchell. Whoever was there, Barry Mitchell, what did he tell you? You sell to me, why not? So whether it's internally or with a customer, they have to sell you, why not? I never take an offer and answer. And with that, I always ask my customer, I always tell my customer, if you are using my network and you're talking to your customers, you're talking to your customers via my network. Your customers are therefore my customers. Tell me who you're talking to, who are your customers, I want to speak to your customers. If it's their customers using our network, they're coming through our network, why can't they be our customers? So let's go and get those customers, because those are easier sell, because you've got a difference. Then, language barrier. Aiden, my favorite. He always makes fun of me, because sometimes I say things. I was saying to a call center, are you... Language barrier can sell for you, or it can sell you out completely, I can tell you that. I mean, I asked in Brazil, when was it? This week. I was in Paul over that night with Brazil to find out exactly what's going on. Why is the Fabio's car? Then I'm talking to Pune. Now, could you imagine an Italian talking to a guy who's talking Spanish and the other guy who's talking Indian, with an Indian accent? And here comes an Italian, I couldn't even understand myself sometimes. So language barrier, it doesn't exist, and language, you know, it's beautiful. I mean, don't let's say French is a romantic language. Then you got the Indian language, I love it, especially when they talk. I don't know how to do it with the tongue. But it's beautiful. And then there are some languages that just cross you out. You can talk to a customer, they don't like the language, they won't buy from you. I sometimes think, you know what, does the customer